Hey guys, it's Mr. Walker here. Welcome to another math lesson with Mr. Walker. You might be wondering to yourself, Mr. Walker, why are you wearing such an amazing hat, right? It's a cool hat, and not only does it just help to bring out the color in my eyes, but I'm also wearing it because today we're going on a safari, right? And this is my safari hat, so we're good to go. I also got my binoculars here to keep an eye out for stuff. And why in the world are we going on a safari in math? Well, today we are going to be exploring the mathematical kingdom and looking for some familiar terms that we've probably worked with a bit in the past that you guys will recognize. But we're also going to be looking for some new terms that we haven't seen yet before and exploring some new ideas in adding more to the mathematical knowledge that we already have. So our main goal for today, if we want to put it in words here, is to find factor pairs for numbers to 100. So we're going to find factor pairs for numbers to 100 and use the understanding, what we already know about factors, to help us define prime and composite numbers. Now, some of those terms you might be familiar with, you might have heard before. Some of them might be a little bit new, and that's why we're going on this safari to rediscover some of these old terms and to learn some of the new ones, learn about some of the new ones in the wild, in that mathematical kingdom, if you will. So you don't need much today, something to write on, something to write with. Maybe if you have a safari hat or some bug spray or some hiking boots, things like that, you might need those as we explore the different things, but mainly just something to write on and something to write with should probably be okay. So go ahead and pause the video, gather that stuff up, and once you're ready to go, click play and let's explore some things. Alright guys, here's our first location. We're in the jungle, deep in the jungle, in this amazing looking waterfall and pool here, or lake or spring, I don't know what you call it, but it looks nice. Unfortunately, we can't go swimming today because we have a lot of math to do, but maybe we'll come back another time and do some exploring, do some swimming. So let's take a look around, see if we see anything we recognize, anything we see before, and just kind of explore this for some math real quick, okay? I'm going to take a look, let's see, look up high, it's a little misty out here, but we can, wait a minute. You guys hear that? You hear that rustling off in the distance there? I think something's coming. Let's take a look. It's an array. Shh, it's an array. Don't scare it off. We have an array right here. Awesome. Take a look at that array. I think I hear another one coming. Oh, there's two arrays. Two arrays. This is exciting. This is super exciting. All right, guys. Do me a favor. Take a second. Look at these arrays that we found here in the wild. See if you can tell me maybe a multiplication sentence that we could use to identify both of these arrays. What multiplication sentence could we give to each array to help identify it? Go ahead, take a second, do that, pause the video, and then we'll come back and we'll see what we found. Awesome. Well, these arrays can be identified just like this. We have 1 times 8, right? We have one row of 8, and that's going to equal 8. And then we have two rows of 4. That's going to equal 8 as well. So awesome. So we found some arrays. Let's dive a little bit deeper and see if we can give some more details on these arrays that we found. Well, this array, like the other array, is made up of factors, right? We have two factors here, and the factors are 8 and 1, and 1 and 8. Those are the factors. That's what makes up the product, which is 8, okay? So these are terms that you've probably heard of and explored a bit before. We're just kind of refreshing our memory as to what they are and identifying them here. Same thing for this guy. It has two factors and a product. What are the two factors in this multiplication sentence? Right, 2 and 4. Those are going to be our factors, and our product, again, is going to be 8. Okay, so if we take a look at this now, our product in both of these is the number 8. So we could say that the factors of the number 8 are going to be 1, 2, 4, and 8. They are all the factors of the number 8. Interesting. Very good find that we have here. This is awesome. Our first location, we've already discovered so many things, so that's really great. But I don't know about you guys, it's getting kind of buggy around here. Got like stuff flying around, biting me on the back of the neck. So let's go somewhere with maybe less bugs and see if we can find some more mathematical terms in this mathematical kingdom. Okay, this one, a little bit colder here. That's okay, the air's a little bit thinner, but I think we're going to find some good stuff. Not as many mosquitoes, so I'm okay with that. So let's take a look around and see if we see anything mathematical hiding here. All right, my binoculars, adjust these a bit. All right. Nothing here. I'm not seeing anything. You know what this inspires me to do, though? You're like, it's pretty. It's good, right? It's good. All right, so I don't... Oh, wait. Off there in the distance, at the top of the mountain, what do you guys see? There's another array. We found another one. And look. There's another one right there next to it. Awesome. We got two more arrays. Take a second, guys. Take a look at these two arrays. See if we can come up with some multiplication sentences to identify these arrays. Awesome. Okay, well, we have one row here of 18 circles. So we have 1 times 18. That could represent that guy. And here I have 2 rows of 18. Not 2 rows of 18, 2 rows of 9. Sorry, but that equals 18. So we have a common product here of 18. Let's go ahead and identify the factors that we found so far. So we have 1 and 18, 2 and 9. Those are all going to be factors of our product, which is 18. Okay? So if I wanted to write that and write it in maybe like order, I could say that 1, 2, 9, and 18 are factors of 18, factors of the number 18, okay? Which is interesting, which is good, but I feel like we're missing something. Maybe there's something else hidden here that I'm not quite seeing. Why don't you guys take a second, explore a little more, see if you can maybe find another pair of factors, another pair of two numbers that would have the product of 18. See if you could figure out what that might be, and that might be what we're looking for here, what I'm missing here. Take a second, think about that. What two other factors can we put together to get the number or get the product of 18? Oh, look at this, guys. I found it off here in the distance. We have 3 times 6 also equals 18. 3 times 6 equals 18. So we have 3 rows of 6. That's going to give us 18. So we had one. We missed one. If we would have moved on to the next location, we would have left this guy out. We would have had no idea. That would have been a bummer, right? So how can we make sure that we found all the factors of a number? If we're looking for the factors of a number, how do you guys think that we can make sure that we found all of the factors? I'm hearing some good things out there. So we could use like a multiplication chart, right? We could definitely use a multiplication chart to help us out. We could think through our multiplication facts, like if we count by ones and twos and threes and fours and fives and just see which ones lead us up to 18. That's another great way that you guys mentioned. But what if the number's really big? What if I had like 92? I don't want to spend all that time counting up to 92 every time by a different number to see what I have. Can maybe draw arrays or something like that, but the same thing would happen. We would be drawing for like ever, right? Let me write out these factors now. Now that we've found all of the factors, let me write out the factors. We have 1 and 18, right? We have 2 and 9, and we have 3 and 6. So I kind of wrote them out here in order. So if I look here, 1 and 18 makes a pair. We have 2 and 9 makes a pair, and 3 and 6 makes a pair. And if I look, even if I explore the numbers in between, like 4 and 5, I know there's not going to be anything else leading up to the 18, because I've kind of reached that middle point, right? And then leading up to 18, there's nothing else there, and there's nothing in between the numbers 3 and 6. So we've kind of cleared off all of those numbers there. Now, if our number was really big, that'd be a little bit harder to do, but you can kind of look at those pairs and know that, you know, we're working our way down from the outside. 1 and 18, and then working our way down the next step, the next step, the next step. So you know, eventually you know there's not going to be anything else in between. So those are just some things you can keep in mind when we're looking for factors, okay? Awesome. Well, I don't know about you guys. I'm starting to get a little chilly here. So let's move up on to somewhere maybe a little bit warmer and see what else we can find. Ah, this is better. So much warmer. Feeling better now. So we're in a desert. We're looking for some more factors or arrays or even multiplication sentences. So keep your eyes peeled and see if you guys see anything here. Ooh, look, off there in the distance, there is a 2 times 8 equals 16. So we got a multiplication sentence here. Awesome, awesome. What do you guys think? What are the factors of this multiplication sentence? All right, well, our factors are going to be 2 and 8, and our product is going to be 16. What other multiplication sentences can we write using different factors that will give us the same product? So let's just think here. Instead of drawing out arrays and doing all that kind of stuff, what are some different multiplication sentences that we can use that'll give us the same product? Perfect. I heard some of you guys say 1 times 16, okay, because we didn't find that one yet. So 1 times 16 was still hiding out here in the desert. Let's see if there's another one. I think right below that, let's see. Oh, there we go. 4 times 4. There's another one that would give us 16. So these are some multiplication sentences that will also give us 16. So the factors of 16 so far that we found are 1, 2, right? So we have 1 times 16. We have 2 times 8, so 1 and 2. I'm just kind of listing them in order here. 4, 8, and 16, okay? Again, before we leave the desert here, how do I know that these are all of the factors of 16, that we found everything that we could find here in the desert? How do I know that? All right, well, in this case, when we look at our factor pairs of 1 and 16, 2 and 8, and then 4 there, 4 and 4 times 4 is 16. When you get to 8, when we get to 8, we know that we're like at the halfway point. So I don't have to go any further because 2 times 8 is 16. I don't have to go any higher than 8 because anything higher than that, besides 16, anything higher than that is going to give us above 16. It's not going to give us 16 as our answer. And there isn't a factor between 1 and 2, so we don't really need to go beyond the halfway point, at least when we're counting up. So think about if we were trying to find factors of 16 and I started counting by 1s. Well, 1 times 16 is 16. 2 times 8 is 16. 4 times, or well, we could do 3 next. 3 times, well, 3 times nothing is going to give us 16. 4 times 4 is 16. Then we could do 5, not going to work. 6, not going to work. 7, not going to work. 8 would work, and 8 is halfway, so that's as far as we have to go. We don't have to go any further. Anything more than 8 is going to give us a bigger number than 16. So we're good there, so we can use that halfway point to kind of help us to be able to recognize if we found all the factors or not. Okay? Awesome. All right. You know, I was cold in the mountains. I'm getting kind of hot and sweaty here in the desert. Let's see if we can maybe find an in-between place to explore a little bit more. All right, friends, here we are in the, an enchanted forest. It looks nice. We got a path here and everything. It's kind of beautiful. So let's take a look at and see if we can find any other equations here. So I'm going to get the magnifier back out here and let's see. Oh, I think right in the corner there, let's see, there's something coming through. Oh, we have another multiplication sentence. Awesome. So we have some factors. We have some multiples here. So let's look at this equation real quick. What are the factors and what's the product in this equation? Awesome. Well, our factors are 1 and 7 and our product is 7. Okay, we know that. That's easy enough. Let's do the same thing like we did in the desert. Are there any other factors? What other multiplication sentences can we write using different factors that's going to give us the same product? So what are some other factors of the product 7? What are some other factors? Take a second, explore the forest here, see if you can find any more factors, then we'll come back and we'll talk about it. You know what, guys, I've been looking for a while now. I can't seem to find anything else. There's nothing else here that gives me the product of 7. Nothing else I can multiply by to get 7 besides 1 and 7. Did you guys find anything? Did you see anything out there? Yeah, see, no, I didn't think so. So how is this different than all the other numbers that we found or all the other equations that we found so far? Right, all the other equations, all the other products that we were looking for, they all had multiple factors to them, more than one set of factor. And this one's only got the one. So the factors of 7 are 1 and 7. That's it, okay? 1 and 7. What about, let's maybe just explore a little bit more here, maybe just kind of turn around a little bit and see if we can find something else. Let's look, oh, there's another guy there. 1 and 5, 1 and 5. Let's take a look at this guy. Okay, so we know the factors are 1 and 5. The product is 5. What are some other factors? Let's explore this a little bit more, see if we can find some other factors of the number 5. Okay, well, again, it's not like I don't like this location here. It's beautiful, but I'm not finding a lot of other stuff. So if we're looking at 1 times 5 equals 5, if we're looking at that product of 5, I'm not seeing any other factors. The only other factors I can find are 1 and 5. Interesting, interesting. Well, you know what this means, guys? I got some exciting news, because it's time for some math vocabulary.
Math vocabulary.
All right, guys, before we explore any more, let's talk about these two terms. Two new terms I'm going to throw out there for you guys is prime numbers and composite numbers. So we just explored in that forest there, and we found two equations, 1 times 7 equals 7, 1 times 5 equals 5. And we were looking for other factors of the 7 and other factors of the 5, and we couldn't find any. Well, those numbers, 5 and 7, those are prime numbers. They have exactly two factors, only the number 1 and the number itself. So 1 and 7, those are the only factors that 7 has. That makes it a prime number. 1 and 5, those are the only factors that it has. That makes it a prime number. So any number, and right now we're kind of only focusing between numbers 1 and 100, but this goes to infinity. Any number that has only two factors, 1 in itself, whatever the number is, that's going to be a prime number, all right? On the other hand, numbers that have at least one factor other than 1 and the number itself, that's going to be a composite number. So some of those first numbers that we found, like 16, 18, 4, 6, any of those numbers that are going to have more than one factor, those are going to be composite numbers. Okay, so there's two different terms there. If you have a note catcher, or if you have a math vocabulary book or binder or something like that that you're keeping some notes in, write these down because you're going to want to know these terms. And then we're going to go back out and explore and see if we can put these new vocabulary terms to use exploring the mathematical kingdom. All right, guys, so I figured we would end our little journey here on a nice, warm, sandy beach here. It looks beautiful. Probably maybe jump in the water a little bit after this. But let's start by seeing if we can find here on this beach factor pairs of the number 35. So think about the number 35 for a second and think, is it prime or composite? And then see if we can prove that by listing out the factors that it has. Okay, so take a second, see if you can find any of those laying around on the beach. Don't get too distracted and get lost in the water or anything like that, but see if you can find some factor pairs of 35 so we can see whether it's a prime or a composite number. All right, so what do you guys think? What'd you find? Prime, composite? Were you able to find a lot of factor pairs? What do you think? All right, I'm hearing composite out there, and here's why. We have 1 and 35. Every number you look at is always going to have that to start, 1 and whatever the number is. But the number 35 also has 5 and 7. That also makes 35, 5 times 7. So this has two pairs of factors, right? 1, 35, 5, and 7. So that means it is going to be a composite number. So 35 is a composite number, okay? Oh, look, we got two more coming in here. We have factor pairs for 23 and factor pairs of 48. Take a second, see if you can identify or find here on the beach somewhere the factor pairs of 23 and the factor pairs of 48. Take a look there, and then we'll come back and we'll see if whether they're prime or composite. All right, so for 23, I have 1 and 23. I wasn't able to find anything else. How about you guys? No, same thing? Okay, so that means that this number is prime. Awesome, this is a prime number. Only has the factor pairs of 1 and 23. It doesn't have anything else, so that makes it a prime number. Awesome. What about 48? Do we find any pairs, any numbers that we can multiply together to make the number 48? Well, of course, we have 1 and 48. We also have 2 and 24. 2 times 24 would give us 48. We also have 3 and 16. Holy cow, 3 times 16 will give us 48. What else? You guys find anything else? Right. 4 and 12, that would give us 48 as well. And there was one last one, I don't know if you saw it underneath the seashells over there, but we had 6 and 8, that would also give us 48. So this is definitely a composite number. It has a lot of different factor pairs, which is exactly what the definition of a composite number is. So awesome, great job, guys. Well, thank you guys for exploring not only factors and products, but also prime and composite numbers. That was fun. Thank you for going on this journey with me and exploring these different locations to identify these things. Should practice with this a little bit more today. Have some fun with it. And just keep an eye out whatever you are. If you see a number somewhere, just see if you can identify whether it's prime or composite. I know it might not be your idea of fun, but me being a math nerd, I mean, that's super awesome to do. So try that out. Try to challenge yourself and see if you can find some prime and composite numbers out there, and definitely practice with this so far. I'm going to get going. I've had enough sun for today. I got to get out and get in the shade for a little while, get in the AC. You guys find your own way home or enjoy the beach, whatever you want to do. It's up to you. And thanks for watching. Talk to you next time.